More than 100,000 people around the world have been injected in trials for COVID vaccines being considered by the U.S. Participants in the trial have reported similar reactions to the different vaccine products. Pfizer's analysis indicates that about 25% to 50% of participants experienced some degree of side effects, while 10% to 15% had a more serious reaction.
I had chills, nausea, a headache, some fatigue, and that just kind of got worse and worse as the night went on.
Kristen Choi is a nursing professor at UCLA. She published a firsthand account of the symptoms she experienced after her second injection in a phase 3 Pfizer trial, including a 104.9-degree fever.
At that point, you know, I suspected that I probably got the active vaccine rather than the placebo, although I don't know for sure. And I took some Tylenol, and the fever fortunately started to come down pretty quickly.
Choi's reaction is considered more serious and rare, but is exactly why hospitals plan to stagger vaccine doses among staff, so not everyone feels lousy on the same day.
That wouldn't have been a day I could have gone to work. I felt pretty sick.
East Bay residents Dan Horowitz and Dr. Judson Brandeis also participated in phase 3 Pfizer trials and had very mild to moderate reactions. They both believe they got the actual vaccine because they have since tested positive for COVID antibodies.
I had a little bit of discomfort in my shoulder. Other than that, it was really a no-brainer. It was totally fine.
Just feeling a little bit funny, but nothing that frightened me. And it said to me, we're going to get through this.
The younger you are, the more likely you are to have side effects because your immune system is strong and responding to the vaccine, which is likely why Choi, who is 28, had a more intense reaction than Horowitz, who's 65.
These vaccines are very immunogenic, meaning they stimulate a strong immune response. And so the likelihood is that if you're having symptoms after a vaccine, that your body's responding incredibly well. It does look like vaccine efficacy remains quite high in the older adult population. So that's all good news.
Dr. Grace Lee is a pediatric infectious disease physician at Stanford and sits on California's Scientific Safety Review Committee for Vaccines. She addressed concerns about the two patients in the UK who had anaphylactic symptoms after they received the Pfizer vaccine last week. Both had a history of allergic reactions.
It may be for whatever reason that they had an allergy to a component of the vaccine. I wouldn't expect that this vaccine would be more allergic or cause more anaphylaxis than any other vaccine at this time.
So if someone's going to have an allergic reaction to a vaccine, how quickly would it happen?
Typically will happen within a few hours.
What's more likely is that vaccine recipients will have shoulder pain or minor flu-like symptoms 12 to 24 hours after injections. Symptoms manifest more often after the second dose. And even though some side effects may be similar to the virus, you cannot actually contract COVID-19 from the vaccines. Bay Area residents I've spoken to in Stanford's Johnson & Johnson trial have reported zero to moderate side effects. As for AstraZeneca, Trisha and Kevin Jiang volunteered for the San Francisco trial and have no symptoms after their second injection, but have reason to believe they may have gotten the vaccine over the placebo.
My teenage son got COVID and tested positive multiple times, and we had to take care of him, and we tested negative multiple times.
For Moderna, new data from the FDA indicates fatigue, headaches, and muscle pain are the most common vaccine side effects.
My stomach felt awful. My head was killing me.
The only thing that was not hurting was my hair follicles.
But Susan and Dr. Thomas Froelich, who both participated in a phase 3 Moderna study in Texas, say it was all worth it. A second study they enrolled in showed Susan has COVID antibodies.
I am so glad that I got this vaccination. I am so glad that in the future, I'm going to be safe. I can go to the grocery store now. I can go to restaurants. I can hug my grandkids. And I don't have to worry. I mean, I feel so free now.
Kate Larson, ABC 7 News.